In this video, we're going to compare Golang versus Rust performance in Lambda functions. Most of the benchmarks on the internet show that Rust is way faster than Go. But with Lambdas, we're dealing with a lot of SDKs and custom runtimes provided by AWS. In this simple test, which is very common in development, we're going to create a Lambda function that will download image from S3 bucket and save the last modified date to the DynamoDB table. Let's quickly take a look at the code. In the Rust Lambda, we're going to create get S3 object function that downloads S3 object and returns the last modified date in UTC format. Then the save last modified function that saves the last modified date to the DynamoDB table. Since the date will always be the same, let's generate a new random date and use that to save in the table. The source code for the functions and Terraform is available in my GitHub repository. Then the Go code. It will be a similar function to download S3 object and then save the last modified date to the database. In both cases, we use official SDK provided by AWS. Now let's compare executable sizes. First, let's compile the Golang that will be used in Lambda. For that, we need to add a few variables. If you check the size, it will be 16 megabytes. Since when we compile Rust for release, it removes the symbols and debugging information, let's recompile Go without symbols as well. By doing so, we reduce the size by 4 megabytes. Now let's compile Rust code. It's going to download all the dependencies and produce a small executable at the end. The final binary is the same size as the Go Lambda function. If you want to reproduce this example, you need to compile code and then run Terraform apply. When Terraform finish, you'll get URLs to invoke Rust and Golang Lambda functions. Now let's use the load test tool that you can install with npm package manager. Let's run 5 clients concurrently and invoke each function 1000 times. Let's start with Rust function. This is the first time the function has been invoked. It will make 1000 requests in around 100 seconds. But you can already see the mean latency while we perform this test. Alright, the load test is finished. The mean latency is 267 milliseconds. You can also see the percentage of the requests served within a certain time. For example, 95% of all requests were completed in under 291 milliseconds. Next, let's test the Golang Lambda function using the same approach. I want to tell you that I ran this test multiple times and the result was always the same. Golang won this competition. You can see that the mean latency is 233 milliseconds. Actually, I expected a different result. To prove that Rust can beat Golang, I decided to simplify the Rust Lambda function by removing extra libraries such as random generator and time library, but it didn't change anything. The result was very similar. Then I thought, well, maybe it has something to do with Lambda runtime, because AWS provides optimized Golang runtime, but for the Rust, we need to use a custom runtime. Well, I decided to create a Golang function using custom runtime as well, as you can see here. And at this time, I was really surprised that by using a custom runtime, Golang was even faster. Let me know in the comments how I can design a test where Rust can beat Golang. But it shouldn't be a simple algorithm such as binary tree search or Fibonacci sequence. It should mimic a real-world scenarios. Also, I benchmark Golang versus Node.js and Python versus Node.js. You can watch those videos here. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.